didn't come today to talk about Moses, but I came to talk about his mama. Are y'all in here with me? So tell me today, Pastor Dave, what's important about Moses' mama? First of all, beloved, I thank God for his mother because, number one, she was a mother of great faith. Are y'all in here with me? For you must understand, faith is the substance of things hoped for. It is the evidence of things not seen. It's Moses' mama that was willing to exercise her faith. But you must understand in the context of this lesson in which we're declaring to you today is in the fact that every born child, every male child born first would to soon be cut off, would to soon lose his life, would to soon be found dead. But I thank God for his mama because she didn't want nothing to happen to her child. How many of y'all in here thank God you got a mother like Moses' mama? How many of y'all thank God that even when you had no business doing some stuff, you did it anyway, even when you went some places you shouldn't have gone, it was your mama that had faith enough to say, Lord, I just need you to take care of my son, take care of my child, take care of my daughter. Is there anybody in here, thank God, is your mama that exercised her faith? You ought to tell God, thank you for the sacrifice of your mama. Have I gotten to help you? What did mama do? She stayed up all night long. Have I gotten to help you? What did mama do? When I got cuts and scrapes, she helped me to heal them. What did mama do? She cooked for me. She washed my clothes. Have I gotten to help you? That's why I can't help but to look back over my entire life and say, God, I don't know what tomorrow gonna bring, but here is the day I can say thank you for my mama. Have I gotten to help you? For all of y'all I shall know the fact of all these earthly things your mama did for you, but I can't help but to tell mama thank you because she introduced me to Jesus. Have I gotten to help you? She said, if anybody can take care of you, I can do pretty good, but there is somebody that got hair that look like lame poor. There is somebody got feet that look like bronze or gold. There is somebody that got nails in the palm of his hand, and his name is Jesus. Is there five of y'all in here that know who he is? His name is Jesus. Have I gotten to help you? But there is not just a mama sacrifice, but I stopped by to tell you there is the ultimate sacrifice. But I stopped by on my way to glory to tell somebody I'm looking forward to not just any reunion, but the spiritual reunion when God comes back. Anybody know he's coming back for a church without spot or wrinkle? He's coming back with a church that loved him and kept his commandment. He's coming back for those of us that want to praise his name. Anybody in here want to tell God thank you? Anybody in here want to shout hallelujah? Anybody in here want to say, Lord, I thank you? He was there. Anybody glad he were there? He was there. Anybody shout hallelujah? One of these old days, he's coming back. He's coming for a church that still loves him. And he's coming to take me and you over there. Where every day will be Sunday. The Sabbath have no end over there. Where there's a street they would go over there. Where there's a tree that there's healing for the healing of the whole nation. Anybody in here want to say hallelujah? Anybody in here want to say thank you, Jesus? Anybody in here want to show and say glory be to God and peace on earth? Good evening to the Friendship Church. But there's one more thing I want to tell somebody. If God has been good to you, you ought to stand on your feet and give him some praise. If God has done anything in your life, you ought to put your hands together and shout thank you, Jesus. If God has been the author of your heart, you ought to tell God, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Ain't he all right? I said, ain't he all right? Ain't he all right? I said, ain't he all right? He worthy. He worthy. Can you say yeah? Yeah. Yeah.